What's up, guys? This is Reno Ranchero with another episode of my Hunger Games Experience series, where I am following around different players and seeing how they do from the beginning of the game till the end. And in this episode, we are following Zavestos. Zavestos is a pretty good PvPer from what I've heard and seen, and so we are going to be following Zavestos in this game. I chose the spy kit like I always do so I can follow the action, and let's see what kit Zavestos is. I don't know if I can get it. Fisherman. Very interesting selection. Fisherman is one of the kits that got buffed. Recently, a lot of the older kits that people consider to be the weaker kits of the game recently got buffed. Among these are Miner, Necro, Pyro, Jumper, and Fisherman. And there's other ones as well that I can't think of. So let's go ahead to Zavestos here, going in to do some PvP action. Zavestos running in and gets a kill right there on a Thor, and then turns around to fight this guy, Ryan36, who he just finished off. So that's two kills right there, and he has to go back. Now I don't know how much soup this guy has, but I don't want to go into his inventory, and I might miss some action. Let's just see if I can hurry. He still has a hot bar of soup and four more soup. But he's, again, the soup is very limited in this situation with the jungle and not having the swamps. So here he is. He's going to try to fish someone over to him. That's a Poseidon, so we better be careful. Those Poseidons can two-shot you with the sword. Zavestos really has to be careful here. If he can teleport this guy to him out of the water, which is what Fisherman essentially does now. Oh, but wait, he's getting hit by Spavo23, and he just got knocked into the water. Oh, and that guy's on fire and trying to hit Zavestos. So this is kind of a scary situation early in the game, and your mobility is greatly limited in the water. So now Zavestos is having to get on dry land and hopefully make an escape, possibly. I think he just has to get his suit back in order. But if we look into his inventory here, Zavestos still has a hotbar, actually. But that is the last hotbar in his inventory, made with cocoa beans. So he really is going to have to just get some more soup, unless he wants to go in and risk it, if he thinks he can take him out with just one hotbar. But when you don't have a lot of soup, you don't want to be into risky combat situations, and that's what we're seeing so far. But he has gotten a couple of kills right off the bat, and it looks like he is going to try to get some space here, get some food from the jungle. So we will come back when Zavestos gets into some more fights. And we are back, folks. As you can see, I was a little bit late, but Zavestos just got a kill right there off someone who didn't even have a kit. He was tracking his combats, and you just saw the tail end of it. He ran in and just slaughtered this guy, who might have been mining iron right there, hard to say. But Zavestos is a fisherman in this game and is doing a very good job so far. Had some scary situations early on, but it looks like he's retreating now to get some more soup. And here's someone here, Super Chickenry. Zavestos is going to turn to run right off the bat. I'm not really sure why. Maybe he has to organize his soups, and then he's going to turn and fight. And it looks like, look at that strafing right there. Oh man, Super was unable to get hardly any hits on Zavestos as he strafed around him and got the kill. So that's a very good PvP strategies right there. There's someone else nearby, Max Jansen. But looks like he's fighting someone else now. Rafflecopter, 2410. Oh man, but Raffle is dead. Zavestos the fisherman just took out a vampire. I mean, you can kill the mushrooms to get meat, but in terms of mushrooms. Oh, but look at this. He just fished. Oh man, that was glorious. What an example of the new fisherman kit. That guy was up there out of reach, thought he was safe, and Fisherman Zavestos just fished him over and killed him. It's basically a kit where you can TP people to you. So what an amazing thing right there. That definitely shows you how great the Fisherman kit is now. And we are back, folks, with Zavestos here, who just hasn't stopped at all. He's just one of those people that will just keep following his compass and killing all of the people who he finds. He's just one of those non-stop offensive players, and that's the way I like to play, so I really can appreciate someone who plays like this. And he is digging now to a stomper, I believe. He's just digging down safely. He kind of sees a hole that looks very suspicious indeed. And he's going to dig down, but he's got to be careful when you're dealing with people who are underground. You just have to be as careful as you can. And he just jumped down on him. Oh, man. I don't know where he came from, but Zavestos was just fighting that guy, Jay Gunston, but he just killed him there. Another kill for Zavestos. He probably has at least 10 kills at this point. Maybe I'm exaggerating, but I feel like he's just taking out everyone. But here comes someone else who just jumped down on Zavestos, but he can't quite hit him, it looks like. This guy here, Pave, he says XD. Maybe they're going to team. I'm not exactly sure. They're not hitting each other. Let's see, it looks like Pave and Zvestos are going to team. So this definitely changes the game for us. Pave is a scout. So we have scout and fisherman team. That is very interesting indeed. Two very underused kit, but they both have pro rank. So they have the ability to choose any kit they want. So it's kind of fun to choose different kits. Looks like they're going to share some resources and some supplies. Let's see what Pave has in his inventory. He still has one of his speed potions, so he used his first one. So it looks like they're going to hunt, and Zvestos loves to hunt, as we've seen. And now he has a teammate, so we're going to follow them and see how they do, and I will come back in a second. And we are back, folks, and looks like they are going to be hitting this guy. You best check yourself. Zvestos just fished him up from the hole that he was underground. Zvestos used his fishing pole almost as, like, to mage him up, and they just killed him right there. It's so amazing how the fisherman kit can be used, and Zvestos has shown us in so many different ways how useful this kit can be. And he saw someone down in that hole deep down, and he just pulled him right up. So that's a very useful kit. Fisherman used to be just a joke kit. People would just joke that it was an OP kit. But now we are seeing that Fisherman is actually a very useful kit. And we are back, folks, with Pave and Zvestos. And they're digging down as carefully as they can, but they have to watch out. They just dug into a big ravine. And there's a guy down here named Diamond Desire, who's a cultivator. And let's see what Diamond Desire has. He sort of put cobble down. I can obviously teleport to him. And we can see that Diamond Desire has a helmet and a chest plate right now. And in his furnace, he doesn't have anything else in his furnace. Diamond Desire, if I can do this right. I'm guessing it's probably a girl. She has pants in her inventory that she's going to put on. So she is almost full iron. And Zvestos and Pave don't exactly have any armor at all. How do you type on this game? But they're going to fight them right now, so this is going to be a challenge. Hopefully they can survive. Pave is hitting Diamond, and Zev is hitting him from behind. This is going to be a very close call, fighting a guy who has almost full iron. They're backing up right now, and Diamond Desire was just killed by Zvestos. So very good teamwork right there. I thought Pave was going to die right there. I thought Diamond was going to kill him as he was walking away. But Zvestos came in with the finishing shot. So that was very great. Two people who had no armor and stone swords going against a guy, a girl I should say, who had almost full iron. And we are back, folks, and it looks like the two of them have found the guy, and they just killed him. I actually just missed it. I wasn't expecting them to get to the bottom of this ravine so fast, but they had a water bucket, or one of them did, and they were able to get down this ravine quicker than I could even get down there, and they just killed off someone who was smelting some iron. And let's see what they have in here. No iron, they just took the iron out. And looks like Pave is now having a helmet chest plate, just missing the pants, because as you know, pants are just a theory. And Zvestos is going to just miss the chest plate. So they just got a little bit more equipped from that kill, and they're riding the water right back out, and Zvestos used his fishing pole to keep Pave with him. It's so interesting how he's using the fishing pole. I really like it. Very creative indeed. So now on their compass they have a monk who is 120 blocks away, and they've really been moving quickly in this game, but I will come back when they start to fight. And we are back, folks, with the two PvPers, Zvestos and Pave, and they're fighting this guy in full iron at the feast, and they just killed him. He was a milkman, and he probably wasn't even close. These two know how to use their soup, and they finished off the milkman. They're at the feast that just got announced not too long ago. It's going to start in just 2 minutes and 40 seconds, and they just took out that guy, and the next closest person is 100 blocks away, a cultivator at level 54, so he's probably going to be coming soon. We're going to expect him to come, I would think. And we have a monk in the same direction. So I can almost believe for certain that these two people are a monk cultivator team. And they're going to be running towards the feast quickly. In fact, the number is getting smaller, I believe. Let's go over here and see if these two are coming or not. If we can go over here, I could just teleport to them, but why not? And here they are. We have, Crimimino. And Pulkaji. See, I'm so good at saying names. They are a team, monk and cultivator, I believe is what I said. And they are heading towards the feast now, so we're going to have a very nice 2v2. I'm going to be rooting for Pave and Zvestos in these fights, and here we go. The two of them are just sort of stalling for now. And a third guy just ran in. It is Mary Swag. Just kind of ran in. It's a brawl right now. This is very exciting. PLG is getting hit a lot, and they're trying to hit them all. Mary Swag getting hit too. Very hard to tell who's on whose team. You don't want to hit the wrong person. So Vessels is going after this guy, PLKGI, while Pave is fighting Cremimino. And the other guy, Mary, is just sort of watching because he's not teamed with anyone in particular. Mary's going to run in and hit Pave, but Pave just killed Cremimino. And then we have Zavestos, who just killed the monk. So now we just have Mary Swag, who's comboing Pave pretty hard. Sorry about that, folks. I had to take care of that. Mary Swag was clearly a hacker, force fielding and speeding around the platform crazily. I had to take care of that. He is now banned. And our team of two is getting this feast with almost full diamond each of them. They are not going to have too many troubles now after this. We have another guy over here, Korumpa, who has just a chest plate. And this is going to be very interesting indeed. I don't think he's going to have a good time. I don't even know if they see Korumpa, but he certainly doesn't have a chance. He was definitely late, definitely missed the party. He's just eating some food right now. Look at him. And he just, you know, he's just turning around. He's like, oh crap, I better run. And Zavestos is aggressively hunting him with his fishing pole, trying to come in and use his fishing pole. Oh, he just teleported to him. Oh man, Korumpa. Man, he is having to run away right now, and Pave is going to come in and get the finishing shot with his diamond sword, and Korumpa, who didn't even choose a kit, is dead. So that is very nice for them. So now we have just two more people that they have to attack. Invisiman is a cultivator who is 300 blocks away, and let's see what this guy has. Invisiman, we go to him. He has no armor, and he's not in a tower, actually. He's just in a mushroom biome, so he's pretty much hosed. And the other guy is DM34. If we go to DM34, he has no armor as well. So this is going to be a very easy finish. They're not in towers, they're not underground, they're on the surface. And it's going to be pretty much a GG from here. It's just going to take some time for our team of two to find them. So I am going to follow them around for a while, and I will come back when some action happens. And we're back, folks, with our team of two, Zavestos and Pave. And they're just having a lot of fun with this fishing pole. Zavestos keeps hooking his teammate, and then he keeps, like, dragging him along. So it's just really funny to watch. And they're tracking Invisiman, who doesn't even know what his kit does. He just said in the chat recently, what is a cultivator? So he doesn't even know what his kit does. So this is not going to be a very good time for him. And we are back, folks, with our team of two. I had some connection issues, and I had to leave the game for a while. And I sort of missed when they just killed one of the last two people. But he was a cultivator, and he just didn't have any armor, and it was just basically an immediate kill. He didn't even try to run. So now they have just one more guy to kill, and hopefully I will be here when they find him. He is DM34, and he does not have a kit. So it's going to be pretty hilarious when they find this guy. He's 500 blocks away, and if we teleport to DM34, he is on the surface, and he has nothing. If we look into his inventory, he really doesn't have much. He's got some soup and iron sword, but he's been pretty slow moving in this game, pretty much taking his time. Nothing's really a big deal. Well, the game's about to end pretty abruptly for him, because we have this team of two that is tracking him pretty close. So I will come back when they find this guy, and we will see what happens. And we're back, folks. They found this guy, and they're just joking around with him. He's just blocking with his sword. They splashed him with slowness, and Zavestos just fished him into fire from flaming netherrack. And look at that. They're just going to have him burned to death. This is so funny. Pave just lit some dynamite, and DM just burned to death. Oh, man. That is so funny. They just used the power of fishermen to get that guy on fire. So now it's just down to the two of them, and Pave just stands in the middle of dynamite and exploded himself. And so Zavestos gets the win. And I will say good game to Zavestos. And that is the end of the game. I hope you guys enjoyed this episode of the Hunger Games Experience. And if you did, please hit that like button, leave a comment, or subscribe to my channel. I would greatly appreciate that. And I hope you guys have a great day. Goodbye.